All right, we're back with episode 2 of our Bruins franchise that we started yesterday. And so this is basically going to be just a simming type of setup here. We're going to be simming probably a few months or so at a time. As you see, we're already a couple months through in our first year. And Bergeron leading us in points. We are in fourth place, playing okay. Rask was injured. If you caught last episode, Rask was injured. Is he back yet? No, he's not back yet. He's still out. He's expected to be back, I think, soon. So these are our lines right now. These are the lines that we are rolling. Offensively and defensively. And that's what we got going on. As I talked about in the last episode, we are debating a potential trade. I have been thinking about a trade. Not something I'm going to do right now. Not right now in this, so early in the season right now, but probably leading up to the trade deadline, we will be making a fairly decent trade, and it's probably going to involve David Krejci. Reason being is contract. We have to think about the cap. We have contracts to think about in the next, maybe not this year particularly. We did extend McAvoy already. We offered him an extension. But Torrey Krug, Brandon Carlo, Jake DeBrusque, Anders Bjork, those are all contracts that we have to think about either this year or in the year coming. And Bergeron? No, he's got 4 years left. See, I think Marchand's all set too. Yeah, so, I mean, our big guns here, Marchand, Bergeron, Pastrnak, they're all set. But Danton Heinen, Jake DeBrusque, Donato, Carlo, Krug, those are all guys that we have to consider in the next coming year. Now, I've looked ahead at potential trades I'd like to make. Again, I'm not going to do it right now, so early. We're going to see how we sim up until the deadline. But I've already been looking ahead at who could be a potential landing spot for David Krejci. Now, I'm setting up my own personal criteria for a trade. First of all, I have to be able to send Krejci to a team that has contract space, meaning not 50 players, but space like, you know, maybe 48 or 47 players, so we don't have to necessarily take a player back. We don't have to take cap back. So basically, we have to be able to trade to a team that has cap space, a decent amount of cap space available to take Krejci, and that has contract space to take Krejci where we don't have to take anything back. So this is going to be basically a draft pick type of trade. Now, I've been looking through here. There are some teams interested in Krejci. So see, Anaheim is interested. Arizona is not. There are some teams here. Columbus, Anaheim, LA, Nashville, the San Jose Sharks, the Blues, the Lightning, and the Leafs. The issues with these teams here is salary cap. Not really a salary cap issue, but they have a full roster. And the Winnipeg Jets. So the team here that I'm finding to be probably the more realistic trade partner is the Winnipeg Jets. They have the cap space. They are interested in trading some of their draft picks. And they have roster space. So looking at this quickly, I'm interested in draft picks. So they are interested in the first. But as you can see, the trade value is in their favor. I already looked ahead at some potential rookies to trade. And Jeremy Lozen was on that list. In prior GM modes, even as much as NHL 18, but even in my first GM mode, I started when NHL 19 came out. I did trade Jacob Zboril. I think Urko Vakanainen as well. I don't want to trade these guys in this mode. I want to hold on to them. Jeremy Lozen, I already found, doesn't develop that well. So I have no problem throwing him in. So if I throw him in, you can see the value is looks pretty even. I would probably have to even throw a draft pick at them that they want. I probably wouldn't give them something this year because I want to have a, this is a pretty decent draft year, and I want to have a good top of the draft. So I would probably look even way far ahead, a couple years out, if I were to throw a third to them. That would probably work. But again, this would probably work in this moment. So if I were to wait and sim up into the trade deadline, the Jets could have a better record, or their record could get worse. And this first round pick, the value for this pick goes way up, and then I definitely won't be able to most likely trade for it, or I would have to give up quite a bit to be able to acquire this first round pick. But it's looking like the most optimal partner overall, the most optimal partner is the Winnipeg Jets. Let's just see for centers what they have depth wise. I mean, we could save a couple of million by going to a guy like Brian Little. But again, the whole point of trying to trade Krejci is relieving ourselves of cap. We want to relieve ourselves of some cap. That's the whole purpose. Because if you look, we have a lot of... Even if we were to trade Krejci, most likely Danton Heinen would move over to that second-line center role with DeBrusk. Donato would move to a center role. Backes could move up to that would probably move up to that second-line right wing. I would want to add a scorer, and I think we could cheaply do that by going to free agency. Not view contracts. And it's Mike Camilleri who is available. He is a sniper. I know he's 36 years old, but we would probably play him on his off wing. He's still got fairly decent stats, and he wants only a one-year deal. It's a cheap deal. So what I'm actually going to do right now, because he could get signed in the next couple of months or so leading up to the trade deadline, I want to sign Camilleri to a contract right now. I don't have to necessarily play him, and it's only for 1 year. So I'll give him 1.25. I'll give him $50,000 more than what he's asking. Although the thing I'm worried about is, do I have roster space? I don't. I'm full. So let's try to trade a roster player right now so we can add Mike Camilleri and not get a rejection from him. We have a plethora of centers. Yeah, let's trade Oscar Steen. We don't need him. Anybody want him, first of all? No. So let's trade him to a team that has roster space. So Dallas Stars has roster space. Can we just get... They're looking to trade their fourth rounder. Can we get a fourth rounder from them? Rejected. Let's see. We'll go to a sixth. It doesn't matter. There we go. There we go. We got a sixth round pick. Now we got two. We were just looking to get a roster player off, so because we want to add Camilleri. Perfect. All right, so let's keep simming here. Again, we're not going to worry about making that particular trade right now. We're going to keep simming. We're going to go month to month, so let's go up until January 1st. And we'll just keep simming here. Hopefully guys stay healthy. Good, Mike Camilleri accepted off. We're not going to worry about playing him right now. Tuukka Rask has returned. So we're going to send Zane McIntyre back down. We don't have any space. We have a crap ton of centers. Who's up right now? Who's injured? So Bjork and Stajan are our spares. Yeah, I'm not going to worry about Mike Camilleri right now. So I'm going to put Rask back in. I am going to swap. Is he fully healed? Because sometimes if they're not fully healed and you start them. So I'm going to put Zane McIntyre back in his spot. Now the thing is here, do I want to start Camilleri? I don't think I'm going to start him because Nordstrom, this line is playing well right now. Donato's doing okay. Actually, the second line's doing better. Whatever, we'll keep it for right now. Camilleri would just be a backup. Of course, Tuukka Rask has been injured, just came back. Now he's injured again. Oh my god. Okay, Zane McIntyre back up. I think I do need to turn injuries down. I don't fiddle with the settings a lot. I keep them pretty much what they're set at for each difficulty. All right. Rask back out. I think he'll probably be coming back soon. It said January 9th. Oh, I'm in December. So he's going to be out for a month. Okay, so not good. We're almost at 500 hockey. Trade offer. Yeah, see, I took Ryan Donato off the trade block. But they want Ryan Donato fourth and a sixth. For a second and a second next year and a third. Yeah, I know. So Ryan Donato's been injured with a sore knee. So assistant coach will replace. Probably Anders Bjork. Here we go, a couple wins here. Halak holding the fort down. Ryan Donato is eligible to play. Oh, Matt Stajan was playing. Oops. No, that's not what we want. It's like I was saying, most likely Krejci will be traded. I am probably going to trade him by the deadline. Again, to relieve ourselves of cap. We have cap issues within the next year or two. If we want to be able to extend guys like DeBrusk, Donato, Carlo, Krug. So most likely, if we trade Krejci, I picture Heinen moving over center. Backes will probably move up to the second line right wing. Donato will move over to center with Kiraly on the left. Camilleri on the right, and we'll keep this fourth line intact. That's probably what will happen, but it's going to depend on what the value of those picks look like. Urho Vaakanainen is available to play, so let's get Vaakanainen back in. He was playing down here. Yeah, we are going to give Vaakanainen playing time. Who was out that was playing right side here? You know what, let's get Mike Camilleri in. Let's get him some games. So let's put him on the second line, spread our scoring out. We do have Zachary Sanushin. He's actually playing well, playing on his off wing. Alright. Keep the sim going here. So we're teetering. Oh great, David Pastrnak is out with an injury. He's coming back the same day as Rask, so we'll replace him. Oh my gosh, Vaakanainen, we just brought him back now. He's out for quite a while, so assistant coach replaces him. Back at 500 hockey. Jeremy Lozen is out. Replace him. All right, so the Buffalo Sabres offering us basically the same thing. No, it's garbage. That's a garbage offer. All right, so here we are. First of the month of January, and Marchand now leading us in points. I do like to look at the stats like this. I mean, I could go to the team stats, but I like to look at it like this. The first line, Marchand, Bergeron playing extremely well. Obviously, Pastrnak's injured, so Anders Bjork's playing. Jake DeBrusk playing okay. Not the greatest line here. A lot of minus here. Jake DeBrusk, Krejci, Heinen, Ryan Donato, Sean Kiraly playing really well. David Backes playing all right. Joakim Nordström, Achari, Wagner playing pretty well. So that fourth line is pretty nice. I don't want to touch this line. We're going to change things up here a little bit. I'm going to put Donato on the offside there, off wing. For the centers, I do pay attention to the face-off stat, obviously. Yeah, let's do this. We got to get this line shook up a little bit. I'm almost thinking of putting DeBrusque on the right side, but we'll keep it like that. So Chara, McAvoy, Krug obviously killing it. Arlo, John Moore, Kevin Miller. So you know what? Let's put Krug up here. Yeah, let's do that. McIntyre, probably not the best. I mean, 6-4-1, I guess you can't complain. Save percentage is kind of yuck. Goals against average is bad. I mean, Halak, you can't ask for better stats, but... Oof, Rask was not good, although it's a small sample size. Yeah, the Pasternak's playing okay. Mike Greslick. So the other thing contractually, too, I'm going to be looking at is probably Yaroslav Halak. Again, not this year, but probably going into this year's offseason by draft day, we may look at trading Halak for a draft pick. Again, I don't particularly like paying backup goalies at the NHL level in this game. I don't particularly like paying my backup more than $2 million a year. I think that's wasted money, because generally your starter, your elite starter, is going to get a bulk of the starts and the bulk of the playing time. I mean, you want to have a solid backup, but as I mentioned in the last episode I did, Daniel Vladar ultimately became my NHL backup. I mean, look at his overall stats. Reflexes, 4 stars. Puck control, 4.5 stars. Athleticism, 4 stars. Vladar develops pretty nicely, and he becomes actually a pretty nice backup. So, he becomes a really reliable backup. So, I don't particularly care for paying a backup goalie more than $2-3 million a year. To me, that's just wasted money. So, yeah, we're going to make that change. We're going to put Backus up here on the right side and see if DeBrusque and Krejci can... Oof, minus 10. I think they've got the worst minus stats overall. Plus minus stat. Oh, and Ryan Donato. No. Danton Heinen, yeah, because Heinen was originally up on this line. So we'll see if that helps. All right, we're going to keep simming here. I'd like to try to get to the trade deadline. We'll go to the first game of February. So Rask, and I think Pasternak should be coming back on the 9th. Yeah, so he's available to play. We're going to continue. I'm going to wait till he's fully healed. So January 10th, we'll stop it. All right, so Pasternak is back. So we got to send McIntyre down. All right, let's edit our lines. We'll bring him back. Yeah, we'll keep Halak. I do have it on auto-rotate goalies. We'll bring Pasternak back. What's Camilleri doing? Not bad. 7 assists in 6 games. Okay, we'll put McIntyre back in his spot. I think there were some players down here. I do like to keep up with my AHL team, too. I am particular about where certain guys play. Chris Breen, no, we want... You know, let's put Emilio Hansen in there. Not bad. Force back of Carlson does... I mean, Ryan Fitzgerald does... developed pretty well in this game. So does Zachary Sinushin. I've seen Sinushin get up to a low 80. We did hold on to Daniel Winnick, Forsbacka Carlson. The thing with Forsbacka Carlson is he puts up crazy shooting stats. I mean, he's already at 147 shots. That'll go up. That should be up to over 200 shots for the year by the time the season's over. It's just nuts. That third line's playing well. Chris Porter, Colby Cave, Jesse Gabriel. Let's put Hennessy in. All right. Okay, no more injuries, please. All right, so now Rask and Pasternak should be completely healed. So we're just teetering on 500 hockey. So Barrow has been injured, so we'll automatically replace him. Good, we have a nice weak break here. This must be like... Jacob Zabarro is already available to play. Put him back in. Oh my gosh. Jordan Schwartz has been injured. Okay, whatever. Actually, our AHL team's playing okay. Lee Stepniak's finally back. He's been injured a bulk of this season. So let's put him back there. Yeah, I know Stepniak and Winnick weren't really signed by Boston. They were just PTO agreements, but obviously in the game, they had to be signed. I don't know why they don't work in PTO agreements into the game yet. But anyway, I did hold on to Lee Stepniak and Daniel Winnick, so they're just down here in Providence, just filling out the roster. Available to play. Well, too bad. Alright, I'm gonna keep going here. We're gonna go up until the St. Louis game. As we're getting close to trade deadline. And we're gonna revisit some of those potential trades I mentioned at the top of this video. So here's a trade offer, Ryan Donato for defenseman Alexander Edler, Vancouver. Nope. Your salary first of all, Vancouver is salary dumping. Yeah, no. Press back, Carlson has been injured. Okay, Calgary wants Anders Bjork and a second in this year and a second next year for an aging Giordano and a second and a third next year. No. The freaking trade offers in this game are unbelievable. Well, let's put Forsbacka back in here. Alright, so our season is not going all that well. So which makes trading Krejci even more sensible. We're not having a great year anyway. No. Garbage. These trade offers are hilarious. Alright, so not... We're right at 500. Where are we sitting right now? I mean, we're 7 points out of a potential spot. Marchand's just crushing it. Marchand sims really well. Bergeron sims well. Pasternak, obviously that line's pretty insane. Minus 16, minus 17, minus 10. Heinen's still at minus 13, but his stats are a little better. Donato seems to be playing a little better. This fourth line's doing nice. I don't want to touch that. Yeah, Krejci has to go. Krejci has to be traded. Krug, McAvoy, I think this is a better pairing. Pairing, rather. Defense is okay. I'm not going to touch the defense. I'm not going to touch that. Rask has just been average, which is probably typical, I guess, even in real life. Halak's... He's okay. Alright, so this is going to make it even easier to try to pull off a trade. Let's see what Mike Camilleri is doing, because... ...18 points, he's a plus 6, playing really well. Yeah, so, you know what, we're gonna trade David Krejci. I'm going to do this right now. Krejci is going bye-bye. We're going to try to go back to... I said at the top of the video, it seemed like Winnipeg was the better choice. It met the criteria that we're looking for. Criteria meaning they have the salary cap to take on Krejci, which means we don't have to take a roster player or cap back. They want to trade their first round, and they have roster spots available. But the trade value is in their favor. So I'm gonna add Jeremy Lozin. I'm gonna see if this is gonna go through. I doubt it. That's what I figured. I'm gonna make them the same offer that I offered before. So we're gonna go to 2021. We're gonna offer them a third. That may go through. So Krejci, Lozin, a third round for their first. Eek. Yeah, if I don't have to, let's trade them next year's fourth. All right, so the salary is an issue. So I may actually, we can afford to withhold some salary. Let's try withholding 250. That means they get him for an even 7 mil. I don't have a problem withholding salary, but I'm not going to go over a million. So let's go up to 750. Nope. This is a pretty decent first round pick from Winnipeg, so I don't have a problem withholding some money. You know what, let's throw in next year's third. I'm asking a lot right now. I don't want to fleece the Jets. That's a pretty decent first round pick as far as value. And they're only thirds. Yeah, so it's the salary that's the issue. I'll go up to 975. Yeah, see, they don't want to do that. Now, let's go back down to 250. I may not be able to get their first rounder. Let me grab their second and third next year. Let me see if I can grab a prospect. Any prospects they're looking to get rid of? So they've got Spartrek. Any Brendan Lemieux, Paul Ford. Yeah, they're not looking to trade any of these guys. We don't need another defensive prospect. We have defenseman prospects already. Logan Stanley, Sammy Niku, Luke Green, Christian Vesalainen's a really nice prospect, but I don't think we'd be able to get him. I know this would definitely go through. I was really hoping for the first round pick. The thing is, if we try to go for the first round pick, we've got to give up one of these better prospects, and I don't want to do that. There are some untouchables for me on this team right now. Pastrnak, McAvoy, Marchand, Bergeron, Krug. Those guys are definite non-movable players for me. I would throw Carlo. And that second line is just not having a good year. Peter Kolarik. Again, Kolarik is a guy that sims really well. There's really nobody else that I really want to... There's Jacob Lauko. Yeah, there's nobody else as far as what they want. I don't want to move more. The thing is, I can give them Backes, but then they're taking on almost $13 million in cap, and they're already having an issue taking on Krejci's cap. The thing is, I could... I mean, what if I were to withhold 1.5? I mean, that still moves less than $6 million off my books. Could I then get... They're first. I want their first. I want to stack up in the first round. Maybe take a fourth from them. Yeah, they still don't want this salary. I'll go up to I'll go up to 1750. They don't take that. Okay, then we're not doing that. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna go second, fourth, and then second, third. I wonder if, I don't even know if they take that. Yeah, see they're having an issue with the cap here. All right, so I'll adjust it. I'll go up to 750. Rejected, yeah. They don't want it. Is Jeremy Lozen maybe the reason? They don't want Lozen. Nope. I'll go up to 950. Rejected. I'm trying a bunch of different combos, so they don't want it. Unfortunately, I think we're probably going to have... This is an issue where we're not going to be able to trade Krejci, I think, for decent picks. We're going to have to trade him center. Although, we have centers. Maybe we could go pick up a right winger, particularly a guy like this. See the way over cap. So that's the other thing. We have to be able to trade to a team that wants Krejci, but that also has the cap. No. I'm trying not to trade within my own division. Yeah, right. I'd like a shooter, scorer. Gustav Nyquist. Well, DeBrusque is our shooter on the left side, so Heinen would be moving. So maybe like a right wing playmaker or a power forward. Timo Meier. Actually, could we get Joe Pavelski? Joe Pavelski would still be cheaper than Krejci. But he does have a year left. That's the issue. We're not a playoff-bound team, so there's no sense in making a trade like that. Kyle Palmieri. He's a guy that sims really well. Cheaper. He's cheaper, he's signed, and he's younger than Krejci. Looks like the value is in our favor. They don't want to give up their second. Yeah. Can we do a fourth and their fifth? Trade accepted. You know what? I'll take that. That didn't go the way I was planning it to go. I was really hoping to get a deal done with Winnipeg, but we'll go that route. All right, we're gonna make some changes. I don't want to do best lines. All right, let's scratch Heinen because Heinen's gonna be our new second line center. Kyle Palmieri will now take over at right wing here. I think this will be good. I mean, our shooting here is really good. It's a good skating line. So let's scratch Donato. We'll put Donato at center. We could put Backes at center too. I forgot he's another option. I think I'd rather have him on the right side. Although he is a better face-off man. You know, let's move Backes to that Let's check out our special teams. Yeah, let's put Palmieri up there. Wait a minute, where's DeBrusque? Oh, he's there. So let's put Backes on the we'll put Backes on the blue line. I want Palmieri up front. Yep, that's fine. We kill Nordstrom. Yep, that's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Bergeron, Pasternak, Dantin, and Marchand. You know what? We'll keep defensemen. Wait. Yeah, Danton Heinen. So we need... You know what? Let's put Backes here. Three on threes. Yeah, let's put... Let's put DeBrusque here. We need our shooters in the shootout. Good. Yeah, so that didn't go the way I originally planned. We have some more draft picks. I was hoping to get maybe a second. But there's some guys I definitely don't want to trade. Pasternak, McAvoy, Marchand. We've already extended McAvoy. We took cap on that I didn't want to originally, but I also wasn't expecting us to have the record that we have right now. I was thinking we were going to be in a little bit better of a position. Chara's not getting extended. I do want to extend DeBrusque, but see what I mean? He gets expensive. Backes is probably going to be a guy that we look to trade come the draft. We'll probably just trade him for some draft picks. So we're going to acquire some more draft picks that way. But again, Carlo, Heinen, DeBrusque, these are three guys that we want to extend, and they want to extend here. Ryan Donato, too. So we have guys that we need to extend. But Backes is another contract that we've got to look to move come the draft. I'm not going to do it right now. Because I don't think he holds... I mean, we might be able to get a second for him. I mean, do we just do it right now? You know what? We might want to do it right now. Again, we have to be able to go to a team... Again, that has the space. I'm even willing to... I'll hold on to half. Oops. Trade rejected. Man, they just... It's like, dude, you have all that cap space. They have no draft picks. I would trade him to the Devils. The issue here is... Yeah, they have... Let's see, can we just get... Because we're going to need... a minor league guy. Tyler Moy. I don't think it makes sense to take on the salary of Backes. Yeah, it's going to be hard to try to trade him. They've got no second. If I can get at least a second rounder. Just figured I'd give it a shot. See there. So now Colorado has the space. They don't want to absorb the contract. All right, I'll go up to 850. $975. $1,250. All right, I'll do that. I'll take it, just to move a contract off. So let's call up Mike Camilleri, which is the whole reason why we signed him, off of free agency. This is taking a little longer than I thought it was going to. So let's put Camilleri in. And I want Donato at center ultimately anyway. So for now, I'm actually going to put Camilleri here because he's got good shooting stats. Oops. All right, so not bad. We have a first, 2 seconds, a third, 2 fourths, a fifth, and 2 sixths. So we have some draft picks to go into the draft with. Not too bad. I do like the Palmieri pickup. Again, he's a guy that sims really nicely in this game. He's having a nice year. Hopefully he can straighten that second line out. Second line was like minus 10, 11, 12, 13s all over the place. So I think that's it. I think that's what we're going to do for trades. I'm not going to trade Halak. I'm not trading Rask in this series. I did trade Rask in my last one. I mean, in the GMO that I was doing when I first got the game, but I'm not going to do that here. So let's just go to the Devils game. I think we're going to call it there. Marcos has been injured. Replace him. Yeah. Vaakanainen's, well, too bad. You keep getting injured, so I'm not replacing you. We made the trades we want to. Nicholas Deslauriers. Isn't he a grinder? 28. Cheap contract, but I don't think we have the roster space anyway. So yeah, we'll just decline that. Nordstrom has been injured. Yeah, we're at 500 hockey. That's why I had no problem trading Krejci now. I mean, we're 12 points out of a playoff spot. I mean, that's crazy that we're fifth in the Atlantic. Buffalo, Detroit, and Ottawa are crap, which makes sense. Who would have thought? Even in my original series GM mode I did when I first got the game, Florida had, like, a really terrific first year of 2019 season. So this is probably not far off from... I mean, I wouldn't agree with the Bruins stats, but PK, penalty, power play, kind of garbage. Where's Providence sitting at? Better PK. 142 goals for, 147 goals against. Yikes. Goals for, man, goals against. Yeah, the Maple Leafs, 194 goals for. That makes sense. Now let's just take a quick look at our stats here. Marchand and Bergeron and Pastrnak obviously leading the way. Krug playing well. Palmieri we added. DeBrusque has been pretty decent. Kiraly playing really well. Even Nordstrom, Wagner, Achari, that fourth line playing really well. Who's leading us in power play goals? Bergeron, Marchand, Palmieri. 11 points for Krug. Power play points. Alright. Who's our leading shooter? Usually it's McAvoy. Marchand. McAvoy not too far behind. Quick look at our minor league stats. Yep, what did I say? Carlson's a shooting machine in this game. He shoots the puck a lot. He's already at over 221 shots. I bet you he'll come close to probably 280, 300. It's just nuts. He's shooting more than... yeah, just as much as Marchand. He's a crazy, crazy shooter. Peter Kolarik, Daniel Winnick, Martin Bakos, Zachary Sedition. And then goaltending-wise, see what I mean? Vladar, he just sims so well in this game. Six shutouts. Halak, Rask. Rask has had injury issues this season. I mean, the goals against is not terrible. The saves percentage is okay. Just the team in front of him is just not playing particularly well. A power play, a penalty kill is not very good. Granted, we have a lot of younger guys, like, still, like Heinen, Donato. Whatever. So I'm going to leave it there. We'll come back, and next episode we'll be able to finish this season off. I doubt when we're going to make the playoffs. We'll see where we end up. And then do all the off-season stuff.